Hello, my name is Micaela Solé. I'm the producer of the film El Hombre Nuevo, which is an Uruguayan documentary in co-production with Chile, which is in the Panorama selection. And it's about Stephanía, a trans person living in Uruguay who travels to Nicaragua, her born country, to find her place and her family.
Mi nombre es Aldo Garay. Soy director de El Hombre Nuevo, película uruguaya en coproducción con Chile que participa en la sección Panorama. Brevemente, El Hombre Nuevo es el retrato de Estefanía Mirza, una transexual uruguaya que viaja a Nicaragua a encontrarse con su país y su familia biológica.
It's a great honor for me to welcome Aldo Garay and Micaela Solé, who brought a very beautiful documentary film, El Hombre Nuevo, to the Berlinale and to the Teddy Awards, of course, too. And when I was watching the film, actually today in the morning, I watched it already, and I was thinking one of the main themes in the film is really a journey back home for the protagonist. And maybe as the first question, you could talk a little bit about what that journey is, going back home for Roberto.
Qué pregunta. Sé que uno de los temas principales en la película es un viaje de vuelta a casa. Y entonces, ¿qué pensás de qué significa eso para Roberto, ese viaje de vuelta a casa?
Sí. En parte es un viaje de regreso, pero no solamente a casa en un sentido mucho más amplio.
Yes, it is a journey back home in a open sense of view. I mean, it's not only the place, but also the
a la casa familiar, a la biológica, al vientre de su madre, digamos nuevamente.
It's the biological family, but especially the womb of her mother, in a way.
Pero también a una casa histórica que podemos situar, que es una Nicaragua que en cierta medida le marcó el destino de su vida, que era una Nicaragua convulsionada políticamente, una Nicaragua marcada por el triunfo de la revolución sandinista.
And also a historical return to the past of a Nicaragua who was very strong hit by the revolution and that political time in which she was adopted and her life was hit by that country and situation.
So the film is about Roberto or Stephanía, actually. Mm-hmm. The protagonist leaves as Roberto but comes back as Stephanía. Maybe you can talk a little bit about how you build the relationship to the protagonist and how the movie came about.
Mm-hmm. ¿Cómo construiste la relación con la protagonista?
Sure.
Y cómo se dio
el vínculo. Es un vínculo que data de mucho tiempo. Conozco a Estefanía desde hace más de 20 años. E incluso la conozco desde el momento que estaba haciendo la transición de Roberto a Estefanía.
Aldo knows her since 20 years ago. It's a lot of time, and he even knew her when she still was Roberto. He was changing from Roberto to Estefanía.
Hacía muy poco que ella se había distanciado de su familia adoptiva, entonces estaba en eso de cómo adoptar su nueva identidad, ya dejando de lado su segunda familia.
In that time that they get to know each other, she had lost contact with her family of adoption, and she was changing and also leaving behind that second family that she had.
How did you meet her? Like, how did you find out about her and then decided to follow her?
¿Cómo la encontraste? ¿Cómo la conociste?
En el barrio.
She lives in his neighborhood.
But also vecinos, yes. Digamos, vecinos.
Can I talk about your past work?
Sí.
Because he in that time, 20 years ago, he made another film that are 8 interviews of different trans person that most of them live in that neighborhood. That is a neighborhood in Montevideo where they usually live. So there he met her, and he did that short interview and short movie, but he always thought about making a long movie about her, and then the time came 20 years later.
Una cosa importante es que me costó mucho como hallar la verdadera identidad dentro de las múltiples identidades de Stephanía.
Yes. That she has multiple identities, and it was hard for him to find her real identity in all that identities she shows and she has.
Por ejemplo, cuando la conocí, me dijo que era mexicana.
When he first met her, she said, I'm a Mexican. But she was not, she was from Nicaragua.
Entonces, ya me parecía algo como singular dentro de la comunidad trans de Montevideo. Entonces, al ir conociéndola y tomar más confianza, bueno, no, es nicaragüense. Bueno, y luego que participó en algún grado en la revolución nicaragüense. Y luego, entonces fue como, la fui descubriendo como a través de etapas y capas, tratando de ir como despojando las caretas y las personalidades que todos tenemos, pero que en el caso de las personas trans son muchas más.
When he first met her, she said she was Mexican. Later she said, no, I'm from Nicaragua and I was in the revolution, because she fought in the revolution when she was a child, when he was 10 years old. And then Aldo continued discovering things she tells when she gets to know you. And she started to get her a mask and take it off, and then the other mask, and started to show herself. And that was a process in the time.
So is that actually a part of her identity, to be that inventive in a way and kind of invent new characters all the time as a technique of survival?
Te preguntas si es una forma de ella de sobrevivir, de inventarse personajes. Sí.
No solamente es una forma de ella, sino es una forma de todos nosotros, incluso de los que estamos acá.
He thinks she has that way of surviving, but everybody has that way. I mean, all of us also has, but she.
But isn't it still that she, because she is inhabiting a very special position in society? As a trans woman, that she's even, you know, forced more to do this in order to survive. I think the opening of the film is so symbolic, you know, when she's with her basket trying to find a home, you know, which is the most existential thing for us.
Yes.
And it's still, she's not really able to sustain a solid life in the way of, you know, having a house.
Yes.
Or,
sí, que lo que dices es sí, para ella, por ser trans, no es especialmente eso, lo de la necesidad de tener una identidad y de inventarse, de, o sea, crearse una identidad, y además como que le llamó mucho la atención, que es fuerte el inicio de la película, de ella buscando casa, que es como eso, ¿no? Tener un hogar, que es como lo básico que todos necesitan.
Bueno, lo que pasa es que ahí hay que tener un poco de contexto de lo que puede ser la realidad de ser trans en Uruguay.
He wants to tell something about the context of being trans in Uruguay.
O sea, el que decide por ser trans, evidentemente se ubica como el margen más extremo de la sociedad.
If you are a trans there, you are in the margins of the society for the, I mean, you are not inserted in society, you are in the outside.
Y también es cierto de que no todas las trans están en esa situación, pero que ella sí opta por un determinado estilo de vida que es como en el límite.
Stephanía especially makes an option to be in the limits. I mean, every time or sometimes she had some possibility of insertion, but she wants to make a point of what she is, and she rejects sometimes to be inserted in some systems.
Yo no quiero ser a partir de la película y del personaje como análisis sociológico, ¿no? Que creo que eso no corresponde para una película.
He thinks he doesn't want to make a social analysis.
Claro.
because he thinks that movies are not about that, but or at least his movies are not about it.
Pero sí creo que las biografías de las personas marcan tu presente y tu tránsito vital.
But the biography of the people are important to look at your present and your life path. I mean, what you do in your life.
Entonces, Estefanía hoy recorre Montevideo con un carrito, con sus pocas pertenencias, buscando casas, porque toda la vida busca una casa.
So Estefanía goes through the streets of Montevideo with that basket, looking for a home because she looked for a home in all her life and she hadn't found it yet.
Yeah, I want to talk a little bit about this. Maybe it's a metaphor of the home idea, you know. And in the film, we very much see that there's no physical home, but is she also maybe like spiritually still finding that home?
Yes, es que pregunta si no hay en la película no hay una casa física, pero tampoco hay una casa espiritual. Ella todavía está buscando como su casa.
No hay una casa física y tampoco hay una casa espiritual. La casa espiritual es una gran intención de deseo.
He says no, there is no a physical home, but also there is not a spiritual home. Her spiritual home is like a big desire that she has to have.
Es interesante la pregunta.
Yes, he finds very interesting the question.
Porque ese refugio, ese refugio interior del personaje que podría ser la ideología.
Because that internal refuge that she finds in her ideology,
que podría ser determinada concepción del mundo, determinados valores, se le derrumbó en ese proyecto de Hombre Nuevo.
Claro. Certain values and certain ideologies that she had very clear fell apart when that concept of Hombre Nuevo fell apart, of new man in the political and ideological point of view, I mean the concept, the political concept of Hombre Nuevo.
The title is very interesting too. It's called El Hombre Nuevo, the new man. Yeah. And one scene in the beginning too is when Stefania actually is in some sort of like office, city office, and trying to, you know, kind of like achieve a sex change. Why is the film called El Hombre Nuevo?
Hombre Nuevo.
The new woman.
Entendiste. ¿Por qué se llama El Hombre Nuevo?
Porque fue un proyecto de Hombre Nuevo, evidentemente que Roberto fue educado sobre algunas premisas de lo que en determinadas décadas se concebía que tenía que ser el hombre.
Roberto was educated in the values that in some decades 70 and 80 was thought a man should be. That was his education.
Pero soy consciente y muy consciente de que el nombre puede ser interpretado como un juego de palabras.
Aldo is very conscious that the name can be understood as a word game, but.
Sí, pero en realidad y sé que esto puede ser, no sé si provocador, pero puede ser que a muchas personas que honestamente militaron y creyeron en la construcción del Hombre Nuevo bajo las premisas de Guevara, les puede resultar un poco agresivo o una tomada de pelo. Yo creo que Estefanía hoy, pese a todos los fracasos y cosas que sucedió, es un hombre nuevo.
He knows that the people that really believed in the concept of Hombre Nuevo of Ernesto Guevara in the 70s and 60s can find it offensive or disrespectful
or tener prejuicios ante
que have some prejudice preconcepts about about what he wants to say, but he thinks that Stephanía, mm-hmm. being what she is today, it's really the new man that Guevara was talking about, in a way.
So the new man being the new human being?
Yes, okay, being the new human being. Okay, yes, okay. That's the concept.
Sure.
Yes.
One of the last questions, actually, because you were in the beginning saying that your understanding of film or documentary is not really purely sociological, or it's not at all. I think that's very interesting. I would never say that. And why do you say this?
Sí, ¿verdad? Que vos dijiste que el documental no es sociología, o sí, sobre sociología, no. Pero que le parece, sí, interesante, porque él diría que sí.
Uh-huh. Bueno, eso es buenísimo, porque me parece que cada película es patrimonio de cada uno, de lo que lo ve. No, a mí me resulta muy peligroso como hacer sociología sobre todo sobre una persona que, si bien es un personaje, porque una vez que pasa por determinados dispositivos se transforma en un personaje, creo riesgoso hacer como sociología, porque la sociología es una ciencia estudiada y exacta.
Even he knows that from the moment that you make a movie about a person, in a way he becomes a character, because it's going through the sight, and it's dangerous to believe that you are, I mean, he as a filmmaker, no? It's making sociology, because it is a science, and you should study, I mean, that. Mm. I mean, he tells stories, no?
Quizás, claro, en el trabajo que tiene alguien que hace cine documental, de tratar de ordenar como el desorden, o no, de la vida de alguien, ese orden, claro, genera como situaciones que están vinculadas a la sociedad que vivimos, que sí que hace que se toquen, se rocen, y que uno diga, claro, esto tiene, claro, elementos como de estudio, de observación sociológica, pero en realidad está lejísimo la película de eso, sino que está cerca de un personaje que está cruzado por situaciones sociales, por situaciones históricas, por situaciones políticas, por situaciones de búsqueda de identidad.
He says that the fact that to make the movie you make to put some order in the life of a person that is the character of the movie, you may think it has a sociological view, but in what he thinks it's his very near of the character, who is the, and he is crossed by sociological, political, real facts that go through him and are like a mirror of what happened.
Y lo que más me interesa es que justamente que las conclusiones sean parte y patrimonio de la persona que lo mira.
And he wants and prefers that the conclusions and the thoughts belong to the person who is looking at the film. The audience, I mean.
Decís, si vos querés interesarte por la parte sociológica, me parece fantástico.
He likes a lot that you are interested in the sociological part of the film. I mean, it's good for him.
También puede haber toda una cuestión psicoanalística con el tema de las madres.
Yes, it could also be a psychoanalytical view, especially when you think about the mothers, these two mothers she had in her life.
Es una película donde hay muchas madres.
Yes. Mm-hmm. There are a lot of mothers in the film, in her life.
Biológica, la adoptiva y las sustitutas, las madres que hacen de madre, las ancianas que las encuentran, las otras que la reciben.
The biological, the biological mother, the adoption mother, and the stepmothers, like the neighbors that she goes visiting and talk with her in the movie, and other women that are stepmothers for her, like an image, not real ones.
So what is your role as a filmmaker in that entire scene? Do you just observe? Do you feel a responsibility? You've built a sort of relationship and talking about some psychoanalysis or whatever, but it's relationships are very important for human beings, and you've been accompanying her for 20 years. So are you still only an observer, or what is your
No, he's not. He's very near. Es de dónde te parás, de si sos observacional o si estás cerca de ella o si participás.
No, estoy... últimamente he como logrado tener una cierta posición con relación al cine observacional que me parece altamente burgués.
He thinks the observational movie films are like a very how do you say burgués? Burgués. I don't know how you say burgués in English.
No importa, pero no.
Like in the middle class, I'm very step away of the. O sea,
porque lo observacional, el mejor, el mejor cine observacional es el porno.
The best observational movie is the porno.
Luego, observar gente que hace cosas interesantes, que vive, que le suceden cosas, y solamente observarlos, y no preguntarles, y no actuar, me parece que no es cine.
Looking at people that make interesting things and only look at them and don't ask and don't interact, he thinks that not cinema.
Que como director me paro desde un punto de vista emocional. O sea, intento tener un acercamiento emocional, tratar de comprender sobre todo y de que todo el tiempo me haga dudar sobre cuál es el imaginario de la persona, personaje que estoy trabajando. Si no, no tiene sentido.
He, as a director, always is in the emotional place and he tries to really understand the person he's making the portrait.
So what have you understood or what's your conclusion?
¿Cuál es tu conclusión sobre Stephanía?
Sobre este
¿Cómo es tu relación con ella?
He tenido muchas fases de relación.
He has been through a lot of
Porque entender y hasta incluso querer a alguien no quiere decir que necesariamente se esté de acuerdo.
Because understanding and even caring about someone doesn't mean that you agree with her or him.
Digo, somos personas diferentes. Lo que sí tengo como un gran sentido de agradecimiento porque, como me ha pasado con casi todos los personajes con los cuales he hecho documentales, un poco uno vive a través de la vida del otro.
He's very grateful with her and also with every other characters of his previous movies because in a way he thinks he lives through their lives and they allow that.
Y aunque la vida de Estefanía y toda su biografía parezca como muy singular,
and even her life seems very particular,
yo encuentro muchas cosas de ellas en mí.
He finds a lot of things of her in himself. I mean, he finds a mirror in her.
Okay. Beautiful. Thank you very much and enjoy the festival.
Muchas gracias.
Thank you.
Great, thank you. Okay. That was the first interview.